The blood of heroes is on fire within us. The ghosts of our ancestors swell with pride to see us stand strong and true. The worm itself trembles when we howl. Hello, 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 and welcome back to Werewolf Wednesday. In the last Werewolf the Apocalypse lore video, we talked about the Children of Gaia, and in this video, we'll be discussing the Fianna Tribe. The Fianna are known among the Garou for their passions for the pleasure of life, their skills and ferocity in battle, and as keepers of the music, stories, and lore of the Garou. Grief and joy, love and war, life and death. Life is a series of contradictions, and the Fianna embrace them all. However, their philosophy is far from a shallow, live-in-the-now concept. According to tribal legends, the Fianna were born from the union of a passionate Galliard and Danu, an aspect of Gaia which they see as the mother to both the Fianna and the Tuatha De Danann, ancient fairies who gave humanity the ability to dream. Other stories tell that the original Fianna were part of a worm-corrupted people called the Firbolg. From one of the Firbolg who repented and dedicated himself to the Morrigan, a powerful fey, a house within the fey folk was formed, until they left their home behind to protect their kinfolk. In turn, they lost their power to return to their homeland, and would form the changing breeds as they are known. Only the Fianna, they tell, recall their origin accurately. The Fianna were once a fractured group of smaller tribes or bands, following Stag, their totem, but associated primarily with their own kinfolk. In Gaul, now known as France, were the Hounds of the Horned One. In the mountainous areas of Europe were the Sky Singers. In the Balkans were the Nightclaws, and the most predominant of all, the Fierce Ones, known also as the Fianna, who called the Western Isles of England, Scotland, Wales, and Ireland home. These Fianna were known for their close ties to the Fae, and fought against the legions of the Fomarians, a brutal and powerful race of nightmare monsters, which they identified as worm-tainted beasts, as well as a rising threat of Fomari, possessed servants of the worm, which the Fianna named in honor of their ancient nemesis, the Fomarians, in what is known as the Fomari Wars. It was during the rise of Rome that the Celtic Garou were finally unified, with all of Stag's children together under one banner. It was this that made the tribe known to the other Garou as the Fianna. The Fianna have had a few good allies in their history, and yet it would seem they were destined to lose them all. The White Howlers, the Garou of Pictish descent who ruled Scotland the way the Fianna ruled Ireland, were an example of this. In an effort to take the fight to the Worm, the Howlers march down the Spiral Labyrinth, a labyrinth containing unimaginable horrors of the Worm, and forever left Gaia behind as their minds were corrupted by the evil of the Worm's domain. When they returned to the lands of mortals, they were twisted and malign versions of their former selves. They were the Black Spiral Dancers, the newest tool of the Worm. As the Fianna mourned the loss of their brothers and sisters, the White Howlers, one of their tenuous allies turned against them. The Get of Fenris, seeing the weakness in the other tribe, set their sights on the Isles and began a war which would last for over 500 years. To this day, however, the Fenrir have yet to succeed in claiming any of the cairns in Ireland. A treaty with the Silverfangs ensured that no fang would ever claim a cairn in Ireland, and the Fianna would in return accept the sovereignty of the Silverfangs in Britain. Around the 14th century, the Fae left the world behind. As humanity encroached more and more on the world, the magic that kept them alive lessened, and the Fae fled through the gateway to Arcadia in order to keep their immortal lives. The Fianna aided them in the best of their abilities, although they would retaliate against any Fae that would abuse their hospitality. Meanwhile, the Silverfangs lost its preeminence after disastrous defeats at the hands of the Black Spiral Dancers, and the Fianna returned to England and claimed multiple cairns there as their own. Many Fianna emigrated into the United States during the Victorian Age. Relations with local Pure tribes, also known as the Tribes of the Americas, were and are strained, with most Fianna taking any unprotected cairns unapologetically. During the World Wars, the remaining Fianna fought to protect their homelands, which were often assaulted by servants of the Worm, who used the war as cover for their activities. Strong passions and a powerful social streak run deep within the tribe. Their mirth is powerful, their love intense, and their despair deep. Introverted Fianna are rare and don't earn much sympathy. Their tribemates tend to harass them to loosen up and enjoy the raucous gatherings more. Garou born have it even worse. Fianna tradition holds that a deformed body reflects a deformed spirit and treats their metis cubs with great severity, and Garou born never hold positions of real authority within the tribe. It's extremely ironic and frankly cruel that the Fianna, with all their hot running passion and love of the romantic, are particularly prone to mate with other Garou and create these children. The passionate mercurial nature of the Fianna manifests itself even in their wolfborn. Fianna lupus take to art readily, though of course they prefer songs and howls above all. Some, both inside and outside the tribe, suspect that this commonality represents a dose of fae blood. After all, there are plenty of stories of the Fianna fighting alongside the she-lords of the fae and engaging in tragic romances with the old ones. The Fianna are organized into different septs under the leadership of a Ri. The Ri is advised by a council of song, usually comprised of galliards and theurges. Ris are independent, but usually acknowledge war leaders of more powerful septs as their betters. All Ris, with the approval of their council of song, select a Tanastu. If the Ri falls, then the Tanastu serves as their successor, if they can pass the tests of the council of song. This prevents conflicts within a sept during a time of war. Sometimes the Tanastu of one sept is a Ri of a smaller sept. An important part of Fianna culture is fostering. A young cub is put under the supervision of an older Fian, usually a blood relative. The Fian has to teach the cub everything they know and how to properly conduct oneself in Garou society. The Fianna divide themselves according to three lines: warriors, in most cases Arun and Ragabash, bards, comprised of galliards and Ragabash, and druids, who include theurges, velodox, Ragabash, and galliards. The Fianna also acknowledge three virtues: hospitality, generosity, and bravery. All three are traits that, according to the tribe, set them apart from the rest of the nation. In some ways, the Fianna consider themselves the guardians of Garou culture. They glorify the war every werewolf is born to fight, they sing tales of romance that stress the importance of clinging to one's kinfolk, and they keep the stories of old victories and defeats. They leap into battle with exuberance, hoping to inspire their cousins to do the same. But even with no other tribe's eyes upon them, the Fianna fight as ferociously as any Garou can. Yet thanks to old rivalries and quick tempers, the Fianna can be a divisive presence as easily as a unifying influence. It's hard for them to resist a particularly well-crafted taunt, or to shake hands with a rival who's spoken ill of or mistreated kinfolk. Some Garou don't take them seriously. Others aren't able to laugh off a Fianna's bouts of temper so easily. It's a good thing for the tribe that they've practiced the silver tongue as long as they have. Certainly, whatever happens, the presence of a Fianna is prone to keep things lively and interesting. I make World of Darkness lore videos multiple times a week, so if you enjoy what I do, please consider subscribing. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Now ask yourselves this, Garou: when will you rage?